Congratulations on hitting the 10 billion milestone this quarter. Maybe you could help me understand how you got here and what is it in the recent past that you think that has really worked?
We are progressing very steadily and quite in line with the plan we had defined 5 quarters ago. We had laid out a strategy. We had defined the areas where we wanted to grow, focusing on around our key clients, investing in the relationship, being bolder in how can we contribute to our clients, and not only as a provider, but truly as a partner in their transformation. We had the ambition to invest into the strategic areas around cloud, around data, around engineering services, security, and this is what we've done over the last quarters. We wanted to develop partnership with strong technology, large technology firms like AWS, Amazon, Google, Microsoft, SAP, ServiceNow, Oracle, and this is what we've been doing. And so I think what I like is that we've definitely executed on our plan pragmatically, but ruthlessly, and we've progressed. We have an obsessive focus on the market, on growth, and this is what we've also done quite well over the last 15 months. Our performance in sales has been positive, and again, this quarter, strong performance in sales. We have acquired very strong talent in the organization. We've made some strategic acquisitions, and they've started to produce results. All in all, I think we are satisfied with the progress we are making.
Also, I wanted to understand what is the reason for the near 10% drop in profit this quarter?
Yeah, one is there's no drop of the margin in this quarter versus the previous quarter. Last quarter, we had 18.8% of operating margin, and this was including exceptional items for about a point, so 100 basis points, the sale of two assets we had. It was very clear that, like for like, the 18.8% of last quarter would look like 17.8% this quarter. So, in fact, we are actually stable. This quarter, we have included 3 months of the Capco acquisition and Ampion acquisition. And those, you need to factor the cost of those acquisitions in our operating margin. And so, we've actually been able to stabilize the margin despite these acquisitions and despite the fact that we've organized a new cycle of salary increase that apply to 80% of our organization. So actually, like for like, we have improved our margin over the previous quarter.
Also, you mentioned that the acquisitions have worked really well for you, and that has been a part of your strategy so far. How do you look at growth going forward?
We will maintain the focus on the organic growth, but we will also continue to do acquisitions. We just completed the first half of our fiscal year. We have enough visibility on the second part of the year to assume that we will be able to show about 25% growth year-on-year this year versus last year, but also we'll continue to do acquisitions that are supporting our strategy, small to medium-sized acquisitions, but we also stay pragmatic, and if there are opportunities of a bigger acquisition, we will certainly not shy away from it.
How do you feel about the increase in attrition?
Our attrition is higher than what I would like it to be. I take no comfort from the fact that, we are not, this is not specific to Wipro. It's the same for every competitor of our industry. It's actually true for our clients as well. And so I think it's a broader issue that, our industry is facing. Having said that, I would say while we obviously are working on ways to reduce this attrition, we also prepared for the fact that it's going to take some quarters before we see a material reduction of attrition. So we have geared up our supply chain, our hiring engine, in order to adjust and hire the number of talent that we need to support the growth we are acquiring at the moment.
What are some of the ways in which you're trying to, you know, get more people on board?
So on the freshers front, we will have hired twice as much freshers this year than what we did last year, and we'll increase it by another 30% next year. We have onboarded about 8,000 freshers this quarter. So I think it's the trend is positive, definitely. So there's a big focus on adding more freshers in our organization. Besides that, we are also doing some targeted actions on for the most scarce skills, if you like. And then we are multiplying actions to connect more with our employees, to create the environment for them that will give the flexibility they want. With a hybrid model, working from home, working from the office. We are investing into reskilling resources as well, so that they gain market value, if you like, in around the new technologies.
Another thing I wanted to ask you was about the progress on the Wipro FullStride cloud services.
You know, we are at the moment growing, you know, north of 20% across the board in our cloud business. We have grown the pipeline more than ever. It's actually today about a third of our pipeline is cloud related. We have invested into leadership to manage our large relationship with our big partners. We continue to invest into capabilities and solutions. We have defined priorities for development of vertical solutions in the cloud. So, and we are also working on the M&A front. So I think it's a reality for Wipro, absolute priority in our development.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com. Do also follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram and LinkedIn.